Mathematics for Freshman Students, Part 21, Self-Served Exercise. Question number one said that let p of x, given that x squared is equal to 1, the q of x such that x minus 1 greater than or equal to 0, let u is equal to the set containing 0, 1 over 2, 1, then show that p of x and the q of x are equivalent on the given u. Here, in this case, since we have two open propositions, say p of x and the q of x, and the universal set U is also given, then we need to show that whether those two open propositions, p of x and the q of x, are equivalent on the given set U. Now, as a solution, let us check whether those two open propositions have the same truth values for the given universal set U. Now here, p of 0 is given us by substituting 0 in the given open propositions p. Then we have p of 0 given that 0 squared, which is 0, then 0 is equal to 1, which is false. Also, q of 0 is, which that means 0 minus 1, which give us minus 1. Minus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. It is false. Therefore, at 0, those p and the q have the same truth value, false, false. Next, let us check for 1 over 2. Here, p of 1 over 2 is given as 1 over 2 the whole square, which is equal to 1 over 4, then 1 over 4 is equal to 1, which is false. Again, q of 1 over 2 is given as 1 over 2 minus 1, which is minus 1 over 2. Minus 1 over 2 is greater than or equal to 0, which is false. In this case, those p and the q have the same truth value, false, false, at 1 over 2. Finally, let us check at 1. P of 1 is give us 1 square. 1 square is 1. 1 is equal to 1, which is true. Again, q of 1, which is 1 minus 1, which is 0, and 0 is greater than or equal to 0, which is true. Then here, those both p and the q have the same truth value, true, true, at 1. Hence, for every a, an element of u, p of a and the q of a have the same truth value. Thus, p of a is equal to q of a. For every a, an element of u, then this p of x and the q of x are equivalent on the given set of u. Number two. Number two, proof by mathematical inductions. 2 to the power of 3n minus 1 is divisible by 7, where n is an element of natural numbers. Now, we have the statement is given here, then we need to prove this using mathematical inductions by following or three steps. Step 1, we need to check for n is equal to 1. Step 2, we assume that it is true for n is equal to k. Finally, we need to prove that it is true for n is equal to k plus 1. Now let us start from step 1. For n is equal to 1, then simply substituting n by 1 for the given statement, that means 2 to the power of 3 times 1 minus 1, which is 8 minus 1, which is 7. 7 is divisible by 7, which is true for n is equal to 1. Step 2. Assume that it is true for n is equal to k. That means 2 to the power of 3k minus 1 is divisible by 7. In other words, 2 to the power of 3k minus 1 is equal to 7m for some integer m. Step 3. We want to show that it is true for n is equal to k plus 1. That means our claim is 2 to the power of 3k plus 1 2 to the power of 3 into k plus 1 minus 1 is divisible by 7. Now, starting from the left hand side of our claim, that means 2 to the power of 3 into k plus 1 minus 1, which is the same as using the properties of exponential functions, 2 to the power of 3k times 2 to the power of 3 minus 1. Since 2 to the power of 3 is 8, then we have 8 times 2 to the power of 3k minus 1. And we know that since 8 means 7 plus 1, then we have that 7 plus 1 times 2 to the power of 3k minus 1. Then this is the same as 7 times 2 to the power of 3k plus 2 to the power of 3k minus 1. But from the assumptions of from step 2 to the power of 3k minus 1 is 7m, then we have that 7 times 2 to the power of 3k plus 7 times m by hypothesis of step 2. Then taking 7 as a common, we have that 7 into 2 to the power of 3k plus m, which is what? Divisible by 7. Hence 2 to the power of 3 into k plus 1 minus 1 is divisible by 7. Thus, the statement is true for any natural numbers n. An element of natural numbers n, which is proved